Gone are the days of viruses being confined to floppy disks and computer networks. No, now they are easily spread through emails or malicious websites. Basically, if you're online, you're at risk. But what is malware exactly? And what are the main signs? And can a supposedly best antivirus truly safeguard your device? Let me explain. So, I'm sure you've heard of viruses, right? But what is malware in relation to them? And what does malware do? Well, a virus is a type of malware. And let me tell you, there is a whole bunch. The truth is, when someone says malware, they could be referring to any malicious software. Though malware is a general or even umbrella term, the intent can vary. The motive could be anything from a money-making scheme that encrypts victims' data in exchange for a ransom, or a spying operation to steal data. Either way, malware is nasty and something that you want to avoid with a 10-foot pole. Unfortunately, this isn't as easy as you'd think. Doing the simplest of daily activities could put your device at risk. So how do you know if you've got an infection? Though there are 8 major telltale signs, for now I want to focus on maybe the most obvious: system crashes and losing access to data or your entire computer. Now, of course, malware can be sneaky and not all malware will make itself known. In this case, the most foolproof solution is a good antivirus, which can scan for threats and remove them, as well as block danger straight out of the gate. 3 antivirus solutions that are more than capable are Bitdefender, Norton, and Total AV. Make sure to never buy any antivirus without a discount. And if you want to save money, I will leave the best discount links for each of these options below, or just scan the QR code now. Remember, modern malware is harder to detect, and not all antivirus providers are going to be good enough to catch threats. In this case, I've found these 3 options work excellently, and to prove it, I ran some malware tests of my own. It went like this. I turned off any real-time protection features, planted some malware samples onto my device, yes, I did that, and ran full system scans with each provider. This was a combination of 100 varying samples, so keyloggers, worms, trojans, and more. My goal was to see how many malicious files each software would flag, how long scans took, and how they affected my device's performance. The best was Bitdefender. It captured 93 out of 100 threats. It scanned over 640,000 files and managed to keep the CPU load from around 18 to 66%, which is fairly average within the market, though a scan did take around 3 hours. It's time well spent, you know, kind of like watching a whole Lord of the Rings movie, considering this detection score is better than the likes of Malwarebytes or Windows Defender. Now, we have Norton. 81 out of 100 threats were detected and removed. Best of all, this was done in around 11 minutes. I found no false positives and my CPU was only 30 to 40%. I also want to mention that with their user interface improvements, you can use features and run scans all in one window, making Norton much easier to use than before. Okay, finally, Total AV, detecting 80 threats in 11 minutes. I admit my CPU usage was high, 80 to 90%, but a positive change is that Total AV's new version automatically quarantines detected threats rather than leaving the decision to the user. This is a much more traditional and safer approach, as it doesn't leave room for the malware to cause any harm while it's waiting to be actioned. Though it isn't just my testing that shows that they are capable. These providers proved themselves as best antivirus software options in independent testing as well. Bitdefender scored above average against older and newer threats from AV test, and 99.6 of threats in AV comparatives results. They even got top marks in terms of performance and usability. Total AV and Norton also got top marks for protection and usability in AV test results, with slightly lower scores in AV comparatives testing. What I want to stress, though, is that each of these providers have their particular strengths, but they still all deserve spots at the big boy table. Bitdefender proves that it's going to detect the most threats out of all the providers I tested. Norton, though, makes running scans quick and with low CPU. Total AV is just as fast, detecting a similar amount of malware, though Total AV's CPU usage is high. They're done quickly, and I can only see it being an issue for older devices. Now, before I talk about particular features that help detect malware, I just want to speed through some other signs that your device might be infected. You know, knowledge is power. Okay, another red flag is that your computer slows down. It might sound simple, but yes, this alongside the fan getting really loud could indicate that your computer is part of a botnet. Getting an increase of pop-up ads that inundate your screen. Yes, this could mean you've been targeted by adware. Your disk space suddenly decreases is another red flag. Your system's internet activity suspiciously increases. This could mean you've been infected with malware that requires back and forth communication with the attacker's command and control server. It's even likely that they're trying to download a secondary infection, you know, because just one isn't enough. Your browser settings change. This could be anything from new toolbars, extensions, or plugins. Lastly, your antivirus software stops working and cannot be turned back on. Or, shock and horror, yes, there could be no sign at all. Whatever the cause, though, the quickest and most effective solution is simple: a reliable antivirus. So while numbers and knowing signs are an important part of the puzzle, they aren't the be-all end-all. Additional features do enhance the experience and value and overall ability to keep your device safe from threats. So let's talk about those. First off, they all have scanning options for different situations like quick scans, the ability to scan specific files or folders, and even deep scans that target the depths of your device. Real-time protection and ransomware protection are other features that they have in common. So the former feature means that each antivirus is working in the background to block and remove any threats it discovers, without me having to lift a finger. That's nice. The latter has been implemented differently by each antivirus. Bitdefender blocks ransomware in real time, but it also has ransomware protection that creates a backup of your files that is retrievable in case they ever get encrypted and held at ransom. TotalAV identifies and isolates ransomware attempts, working alongside real-time protection. And Norton's is similar to Bitdefender, blocking ransomware in real time, but also offering a cloud backup option feature as well, which safely stores copies of your data. With that said, what antivirus is the best in terms of extra features? Bitdefender has anti-theft, which helps you locate and lock a lost device, alongside anti-tracking and anti-spam capabilities that independently work at browser or email level to protect your privacy and security. The list of additional protection, performance, and privacy features is pretty long, making Bitdefender one of the most feature-heavy antivirus options. Just keep in mind that many extras are only accessible with the more expensive plans, such as their privacy firewall, password manager, and device optimizers. They have a VPN, but without paying extra, it is really limited at 200 megabytes of data a day. Uniquely, Bitdefender has a crypto mining protection tool, helping users avoid unauthorized system breaches, electricity theft, and other security risks. Norton has system optimizations too, alongside dark web monitoring, parental controls, a VPN, and a password manager, depending on which plan you subscribe to. They even have one of the most comprehensive and customizable firewalls that I've ever used. If your budget allows it, the most expensive plan has some useful identity theft features as well. So how does TotalAV compare? Though lacking a firewall or an overly long list of features, it is nice that most of their subscriptions include the same tools like the system tune-up, disk cleaner, or even Adblocker extension for safer browsing. It's only the really advanced features like the VPN or password manager that are limited to the more expensive plans. All in all, each of my recommendations has a great amount of features to enhance your device security. Bitdefender might have the most, but Norton offers similar features with more of their plans, and TotalAV keeps it simple, giving users very similar experiences regardless of which subscription they choose. Speaking of subscriptions, let's evaluate pricing. While each of my best antivirus 2024 recommendations are fairly priced, considering their good detection, usability, and features, the most affordable entry-level plan right now is Norton. TotalAV's cheapest plan is a similar price, and Bitdefender costs the most, but considering their high detection rates, I'd say that it's still worth it. Though, if you want to stay protected at the best price possible, remember I do have links below. So these will take you to an updated pricing page with details already applied. So each provider comes with a money-back guarantee, making the sign up entirely risk-free. All right, be sure to stay safe out there. And if you have any questions, I'll try my hardest to get back to you. Just drop it in the comments section. Okay, bye for now.